In here, I have a mix of peppers, red bell peppers, scotch bonnet, garlic, ginger, and onion that I'm going to use my food processor to finely chop for the soup. I'm going to do the same for my frozen tomatoes too. Now to a dry pan, I'm going to add some palm oil, about 2 cooking spoons, and just let it melt, okay? In goes my onions. I'm gonna let this fry a bit. Okay. Then my pepper mix. Make sure that you're always controlling your heat so that you do not burn up anything, okay? I think this is enough. Okay, I'm gonna let this fry before I come back to add my tomato. Okay, now in goes my tomato. It's not a lot. It looks like a lot, but it's not a lot. It's because it's frozen, so I'm going to add that to my meat. Okay. And I'll mix again and I'll allow it to fry even more, okay? I'm going to cover and allow to fry. Okay, now that our sauce is fried, I'm going to proceed to add in our protein. For this, I'm using beef. I'm also going to be adding a little bit of the stock. I have a lot of stock. I cook this using a pressure pot. So add some of the stock and then mix this well. Okay. At this point, I'm going to also add some stock cubes and salt. Sorry for the shaky video. I'm doing this with one hand. I'm cooking with the next, okay? So I'm going to add some stock cubes. Okay. I'm not going to add salt yet. Whenever I'm making anything that has vegetable or cooking any soup at all, I like to add my salt in last, okay? So that all the liquid would have been reduced and I'll be sure of the taste before I know if I'll need to add any more salt or not. Okay, so I'm going to mix this well and then I'm going to add in my groundnuts. Okay, see, it's just finely grounded almost. I'm then going to add in my groundnuts. It's milled but it's not completely smooth. It still has a little bit of chunks in it. I'm going to pour that in and then stir well. Just like a typical groundnut soup. Okay. I love the color. I'm going to go in and add some curry and some thyme. Okay, for some more flavor, but I'm also going to add a little bit of crayfish. Just for another depth of flavor, okay? Just a little, like a tablespoonful. Okay, like this amount. Just to add another depth of flavor, that's all. Not like I really need, okay? Oh, and I like that kind of local flavor that it gives to soups as well. So I'm going to mix this in very well. Now the typical groundnut soup that you use to eat sonasser is not thick, okay? So as I cook, I'm going to be thinning this soup a bit. I still have some of my beef stock left, okay? So I'm going to pour in some more because I want this to be as loose as possible. I don't want a thick consistency, okay? I've gone ahead to add some curry and thyme and add in the rest of that stock. Okay, so we have the consistency very thin. It's meant to be a thin soup, not a thick soup. And to this, I'm also going to add basil, also known as scent leaf here. Yes, guys, this soup is usually so flavorful, you'll almost bite your fingers, okay? I'm going to mix this in and allow it to cook a bit before I come back to add my vegetables, and our soup is ready. Okay, so this is our soup. Lastly, I'm going to add in some greens. Or alehu, as we call it here in the north. F4, I think Yoruba people call it F4. That's what I'm adding, okay? And I'm going to quickly mix this and then bring it, take it off of the fire, because I don't want the vegetable to cook too much. Besides sonasser, you can also use this to eat your tuwon shinkafa and even to eat rice, really. Okay. So, yep. I didn't need to add any salt because there was enough salt in our stock. And our soup is ready. Now we will proceed to making our sonasser.